got to share some really great news with you. Well, Nashwa, you already heard about this, right? You remember what's happening in the Harbinger community in late June?
We are going on a retreat.
Oh, we're going on a field trip. We're going on a retreat. Harbinger has hired, get this, Henry, Shaadie, you guys will be excited about this. We've hired Sophie Gregoire-Trudeau to conduct an entire weekend retreat of yoga with the entire Left podcast gang. I can't wait. It's going to be so great. Because basically, you know, it's been like a long and intense year, and the Harbinger Media Network is offering our staff a unique event to help them cope with the stress of the pandemic. We're gonna have a great time. So Nashwa, how much are you looking forward to this unique experience?
Highlight of my summer.
Yeah, it's going to be good. Well, Ottawa is a great place to visit, and there's just like a lot of fun stuff to do there. So, Henry, I understand that you are a massive fan of probably the most impressive statue in the entirety of our nation's capital. You like the Mama Spider sculpture, Henry, isn't that right?
Yeah, I love it. I love it. I think it's, you know, it's scary, but it sends a message.
Yeah, it sends a message. I wonder what that message is. Shaadie, you're, you know, as an engineer, you were especially interested, of course, in the Diefenbunker. This is the Cold War era bunker created by the Diefenbaker government. So you see the portmanteau they did there, the Diefenbunker. And they actually have escape rooms now, which actually would be incredibly cool in the Diefenbunker. So that's awesome. But Nashwa, besides the really
fun... Yeah, I was going to make fun of this, but that actually looks kind of cool.
And Nashwa, of course, you're into sort of like dark tourism. I know that about you. So you're really looking forward to going to the jail hostel, correct?
Yeah, love a good hostel.
Oh man, it's so grim.
In which location are we doing the yoga? Is it under the spider or in the bunker?
Well, apparently Sophie has a whole agenda where we'll be doing it in like multiple places all over the city, which is going to be really, really cool. Yeah, it's really cool. So we're going to have a good time. And that's just, you know, that's just how Harbinger, we spend all our money that we get, sort of treating our hosts right. And I think that that's really important.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you guys, I haven't actually ever lived in Ottawa, but I know someone who has. Friend of the show, James, was a Senate page in Ottawa in, I think, 2015 and 2016. And he has a few opinions about our nation's capital. Yes, he's always courting controversy. Harbinger Society's Atlantic correspondent routinely reports from Prince Edward Island on every episode, where he's sequestered in an unidentified rural location while his home base of Montreal continues to be racked by pandemic panic. This is Solitary Thoughts with James Brown.
It's 2021 and our federal government is still carrying on with the vastly unpopular Victims of Communism Memorial. This memorial has been in the works for over a decade. It's seen site changes, redesigns, and a federal budget of $3 million, then $0 million, then $1.5 million, then $5.5 million, and now, well, who knows how much it really costs now. And while people have slammed the memorial for being partisan, unnecessary, costly, hypocritical, and 100 other things, to me there's one major problem with this structure. The average Ottawan just doesn't really think about communism. And since it's the fine people of Ottawa that are going to have to look at this thing, why not give them a memorial that actually speaks to an Ottawa-specific issue? Instead of making a Victims of Communism memorial, we should make a memorial for something that's victimized Ottawans young and old. That's why I'm proposing a memorial for the victims of the Rideau Street McDonald's. For anyone unfamiliar, this infamous McDonald's is located at 99 Rideau Street, just 400 meters from Parliament Hill. It's been called a public safety concern by Ottawa's mayor and a national historic site by, well, me. You can get a pretty good idea of the place by searching, quote, McDonald's UFC, end quote, on YouTube. The video shows no less than 15 grown men engaged in a full-on brawl right there on the floor of Rideau McDonald's. While the fight itself isn't fun to watch, it's sort of sad, really. Absolute magic happens 38 seconds into the video. Moments after someone in a purple shirt sucker punches a guy wearing a backpack, in the midst of five different simultaneous fistfights, a man reaches into his jacket and pulls out a raccoon. In the midst of chaos, this man holds his raccoon by the scruff of its neck and just displays it for everyone to see. Someone starts shouting, "This guy has a raccoon! This guy has a raccoon! This guy has a raccoon! Like, this guy has a motherfucking raccoon!" But by that time, the raccoon is back in its jacket and the guy is smoking a cigarette. As suddenly as it began, the fighting stops. This man and his raccoon have brought peace to the Rideau Street McDonald's. The monument will be a solid bronze statue of that man and his raccoon. It will stand 99 feet high and it will cost $4 million McDollars to build. Fighting will not be allowed near the monument, but smoking will be encouraged. And it will be recognized across the country as a tribute to all residents of Ottawa, the victims of the Rideau Street McDonald's.
$4 million McDollars is a lot of money to pay for practically anything. But for that statue, I think this might be bold to say, but I think it's worth it. Wouldn't you agree, Nashwa?
Yeah. And I think, I don't know. I think that Ottawa McDonald's, I think the Toronto Queen Spadina McDonald's can give it a run for its money.
Ooh.
If anybody's from Toronto, do you know which one I'm talking about, Henry? That McDonald's is like...
I'm not a McDonald's guy.
Oh, Henry's I avoid it generally. Fit and healthy. No, that McDonald's, okay, that can give also the Ossington McDonald's a run for its money. But yeah, the victims of communism monument, it kind of fuels this like Red Scare bad thing that we still have going on in Canada. And I think American leftists always are thinking about how there's still like elements and like sentiment of Red Scare there. But I think Canada, it's way worse. I don't know if Henry would agree. Shaadie can weigh in if he has that range.
Yeah, Henry, what do you think?
So what I think is kind of damning, like when I went on the website of the private foundation, which is spearheading this, I think it's called like Tribute to Liberty. Mm-hmm. When I went on their website, like, first off, it's exactly what you'd expect. Their social media, they're posting, like, they're literally posting Jordan Peterson videos where Jordan Peterson is, like, debunking the Communist Manifesto. And it's just, so it's like the lowest level sort of anti-communist discourse on the internet. And then I was checking out the supporters. I was expecting to see, like, private donors or whatever. But instead, they have a list there of letters from every major political party in Canada. So when it was announced, the Liberals, the NDP, which I was like, you know, maybe not surprised about seeing, there, the Conservatives, obviously, they got like Jason Kenney on there, Stephen Harper, and Elizabeth May too, making mm-hmm. an appearance. So everyone was on board for this.
Well, the origins of this monument, this laughable monument, are kind of uncanny because it's like way back in 2007, Jason Kenney, now the Premier of Alberta, the very successful Premier of Alberta, he was the Secretary of State for Multiculturalism in the Harper government. And he's such a freak. So basically, he went to a private park owned by the Czech and Slovak community in Toronto with the Czech ambassador. And he saw a statue called Crucified Again, which is a statue of a tortured man crucified on a hammer and sickle. And it was commemorating victims of Soviet oppression. So Kenny was like, hey, I think the public would really like to see a monument like this. And they talked about creating the memorial in Ottawa. So Tribute to Liberty was founded the next year as a charity with the mission of building a monument to the victims of communism. And the 9-member board is like all sorts of people from different former communist states. So there's been this like long saga of it coming into existence. It was basically like a pet project of these complete dipshits during the Harper era. But then my impression from just like researching it a bit is that the Trudeau Liberals just kind of like couldn't do much about it because it was like it was hard to actually stop. So they basically like slimmed down the price from like X amount of money to like half as much. Mélanie Joly, who's the Canadian Heritage Minister, she kind of like worked to downplay the sort of anti-communist aspect of it. But I'm going to read the description of what this looks like. And Sadie, maybe you can tell me if this sounds amazing to you. So the Arc of Memory features two gently curving wall-like metal frames, 21 meters in length and 4 meters in height. The walls support 4,000 short bronze rods, densely arranged along 365 steel fins, each one pointing at a unique angle of the sun for every hour of every day across a year. The memorial would be split in the middle at winter solstice, the darkest day of the year, inviting visitors to step through in a metaphorical journey from darkness and oppression to lightness and liberty. I mean, it's inspiring to like to hear that description. That would be something worth visiting, wouldn't it?
That's beautiful. I'm booking my flight right now.
Right. Well, yeah, this is a reason for an American to kind of like try to cross the border and get in on this.
Hear the full episode by supporting Canada's Left podcast community for just $3 a month at harbingermedianetwork.com.